Assalamu alaikum, shalom alaikum, brothers and sisters. In this unique video, we are going to talk about some Jewish questions asked to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. Now, actually, there are a variety of questions related to this topic, meaning Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was asked many questions by Jews many times and many occasions. So, let's get into it. The first set of questions that Prophet Muhammad was asked are as follow. Actually, one day some Jews asked Prophet Muhammad these questions. There were two Jewish famous scholars in Medina. Number one was Uqba bin Mayyad and another was Nadir bin Harith. So these two scholars, Jewish scholars, sent some Jews to Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, with these questions. So the questions are, question number one, tell us about a young man who went into another world's time period. The question number two, tell us, O Prophet Muhammad, about a person who conquered land from east to west. Question number third, explain soul. Hearing these questions, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, said to them that he will reply them the day after tomorrow. But he, peace be upon him, forgot to say inshallah. That's why there was no wahi from Allah. After 15 days, Surah Kahf was revealed, descended from Allah. So the answer Prophet gave to these questions were, the first question, tell us about young men who went into another world's time period. The answer to this question was, so Surah Kahf here replies this question, first question, that is, who were the young men, you know, who went into another world's time period. So this was the verse 9. It says, أَمْ حَسِبْتَ أَنْ أَصْحَابِ الْقَهْفِ وَرَكِيمِ كَانُوا مِنْ آيَاتِنَا عَجَبًا. Or have you thought that the companions of the cave and the inscriptions were among our signs a wonder? Then the verse says, فَزَّرَفْنَا عَلَىٰ آزَانِهِمْ فِي الْقَهْفِ سِنِينَ عَدَدًا. So we cast a cover of sleep over their ears within the cave for a number of years. And this verse says, they will say there were three, the fourth of them being their dog. And they will say there were five, and the sixth of them being dog, guessing at the unseen. And they will say there were seven, and the eighth of them was their dog. Say, O Muhammad, my Lord is most knowing of their number. None knows them except a few. So don't argue about them except with an obvious argument. And do not inquire about them among from anyone. So what is said in this verse is, when the Jews, you know, asked the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, the question, first question, tell us about those people who went into another world's time period. Tell us, O Prophet Muhammad, about those people. So this verse is the reply to that question. Actually, this verse says, you know, replies to the Jews that there were some people in the, you know, cave, and they were sleeping there for many thousands of years. Then some people will say they were poor and their dog was fifth, or some people will say they were five and their dog was sixth. Some will say they were seven persons and their dog was eighth, and so on and so on. But the actual number is unknown. Only Allah knows the actual number of those sleepers. Now, in Bible, there is also a seven sleeper story, seven sleepers. But the question was asked by the Jews. So the Jews have nothing to do with the New Testament. But in Old Testament, same story is there, but there are only three persons in the cave. Now, coming to the question number two. The question number two, tell us about a person who conquered land from east to west. And the same surah, Surah Al-Kahf, verse number 83, gives the reply to this second question. Meaning, who the Jews asked Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, who was the person, the human, who conquered the land, the earth, from east to the west? Prophet Muhammad gave this answer to those Jews, because this was revealed by Allah. So this is 83 verse. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنْ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ قُلْ سَأَتْلُو عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا. And they ask you, O Muhammad, about Dhul-Qarnayn. Say, I will recite to you about him a report. But what is Dhul-Qarnayn's root? This root word, it has meaning Dhul-Qarnayn, meaning the one who has two horns on his head, two horned person. Now, this was the second question that Jews asked Prophet Muhammad, that who was the person, the mighty person, powerful person, who conquered the land from east to west? So that Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, replied them in the same surah, Surah Al-Kahf. So this verse 83, يَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ قُلْ سَأَتْلُو عَلَيْكُمْ مِنْهُ ذِكْرًا, meaning, you are asking me, O Prophet, they are asking you about ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ, you know, the person who conquered land, earth, from east to west. Tell them, I will tell you, who was ذِي الْقَرْنَيْنِ. So the verse 84 says, from the same surah, Al-Kahf, إِنَّا مَكَّنَّا لَهُ فِي الْأَرْضِ وَأَتَيْنَاهُ مِنْ كُلِّ شَيْءٍ سَبَبًا. Indeed, we established him upon the earth and we gave him to everything away. Okay, now, then the next verse says, until when he reached the setting of the sun, then this Dhul-Qarnayn, you know, the question number two, Jews asked Prophet Muhammad that who was the person who conquered almost the earth, major part of the earth. So, this is what Quran says about that person. Until when he reached the setting of the sun, meaning when Dhul-Qarnayn, when the person who was conquering land, when he reached, where he reached, where the sun sets, he found it as if setting in spring of dark mud, and he found near it a people. Allah said, O Dhul-Qarnayn, either you punish them or else adopt among them a way of goodness. Then Allah said to Dhul-Qarnayn, that either you punish these people, you punish them for their sins, or you advise them, you educate them so that they can adopt goodness. And some scholars say Dhul-Qarnayn was the Alexander the Great. Who knows? Now, coming to the next part of this third question that Prophet Muhammad was asked, explain, O Prophet, what is soul? So this is the answer from Quran. وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحِ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي وَمَا أُوتِيتُمْ مِنْ عِلْمِ إِلَّا قَلِيلًا. Meaning, Al-Bukhari recorded in his tafsir of this ayah that Abdullah bin Musayyad said, while I was walking with the Prophet on a palm and he was resting on a palm leaf stalk, some Jews passed by. Some of them said to the others, ask him about the ruh, soul. Some of them said, what urges you to ask him about that? Others said, do not ask him, lest he gives you a reply which you do not like. But they said, ask him. So they asked him about the ruh. The Prophet kept quiet and did not give them answer. And I knew that he was receiving revelation. Yes, Prophet was receiving revelation at the same time the Jew asked him the question about the soul. So the Prophet was receiving the revelation. So he was quiet for some time. So I stayed where I was. When the revelation was complete, the Prophet said, okay, now the Jibreel finishes, you know, job set by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So Jibreel alayhi salam, you know, left the Prophet. Then Prophet got the, you know, the revelation. And Prophet said to them, to the Jews, وَيَسْأَلُونَكَ عَنِ الرُّوحِ قُلِ الرُّوحُ مِنْ أَمْرِ رَبِّي. Meaning this verse was revealed then when the Jews asked Prophet Muhammad about the soul. Now, and they ask you concerning the ruh, the spirit, say, the ruh, the spirit, is one of the things, the knowledge of which is only with my Lord. This context would seem to imply that this ayah was revealed in Al-Madinah and that it was revealed when the Jews asked him the question in Al-Madinah. Although the entire surah was revealed in Mecca, this may be answered with the suggestion that this ayah may have been revealed to him in Al-Madinah a second time, after having previously been revealed in Mecca. You remember that, or that he was divinely inspired to respond to their question with a previously revealed one. In short, when they asked Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, about soul, spirit, ruh, Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, told them, actually Allah told Prophet Muhammad, then Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, told them, the Jews, that the soul is something, you know, you cannot know it. Common people cannot know it. A human cannot know what is soul, you know. Only Allah knows the best. So these three questions were asked to Prophet Muhammad in one time. Another time, what happened? There were some more questions that Jews asked Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. So another time, Al-Bukhari rahmatullahi ala reported that Anas radiallahu anhu narrated that when Abdullah bin Salam radiallahu anhu heard about the arrival of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam to Medina, he came to him and asked him about some things, saying, I will ask about three things that none except a messenger knows. What is the first sign of the hour? What is the first meal that the devilers of heaven paradise eat? Why is it that child sometimes resembles his father and other times his mother? The Prophet said, Jibreel informed me about this earlier, Ibn Salam. Ibn Salam said, that is the Jew's enemy from the angels. Who? Jibreel is the enemy of Jews. The Prophet said, as for the first sign of the hour, it is fire that gathers the people from the east and the west. As for the first meal that the dwellers of paradise eat, it is a portion of the fish liver. As for the child, if the water, that is sperm, if the water of the man, sperm of man, comes before that of the woman, the child resembles his father. And if the mother's water comes first, then the child resembles her. Meaning, during intercourse, if man comes first, the child will resemble him. If woman comes first, the child will resemble her. That's it, simple logic. And thereupon, Ibn Salam said, I bear witness that none has the right of being worshipped but Allah, and that you are his messenger. Then Ibn Salam said, O Prophet, the Jews are people of falsehood. So ask them about me before they realize that I have become Muslim. The Jews came and the Prophet asked them, how do you create Abdullah bin Salam with your community? They said, Abbas and the son of Abbas. Thereupon the Prophet said, what if Abdullah bin Salam becomes Muslim? They said, may Allah protect him from that. The Prophet said, then repeated the same question, and the Jews repeated the same answers. At that time, Abdullah bin Salam came out to them and said, I bear witness that none has the right to worship but Allah, and that Muhammad is last messenger. Thereupon the Jews said, he's our worst and the son of our worst. Okay, so now let us go to this riwayah. Ahmad Rahimullah reported that Ibn Abbas said, a group of Jews came one day to the Prophet and said, O Abul Qasim, remember here, they never accepted Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, as Prophet. So they never called him Muhammad Rasulullah, but they called him Abul Qasim. So Prophet said, they said, O Abul Qasim, tell us something that only true messenger of Allah knows. The Prophet said, ask me about whatever you wish, but promise me by the name of Allah and by the covenant Prophet Yaqub alayhi salam took from his son, that if I tell something that you know, then you will follow me and become Muslims. They said, that's for you. Thereupon they said, tell us about the following four things. Tell us about the meal that Israel forbade himself before the revelation of Torah, and tell us about the water sperm of woman and the water of the man. How is the male child formed from that? And tell us this illiterate prophet during his prophet during his sleep, and who is his guardian from the angels. The Prophet said, do you accept by the covenant of Allah that you will follow me if I inform you? They gave him as much as covenant and promised as he wished. Then the Prophet said, I ask you by the one who revealed the Torah to Musa, do you know that Israel Yaqub fell badly sick and his sickness took a long time? Then he made a vow to Allah that he would forbid on himself the food he liked most if Allah cures him. and the food he liked most was camel meat. And the drink was camel milk. They said yes. Again, according to Jewish law, camels, you can watch my video in the playlist here about kosher and halal foods. So camel has split hooves. Camel does not have split hooves, so it is not lawful for Jews to eat anyways. Now, O Allah, testify against them. Then Prophet Muhammad, said to God, Allah, that, look, O God, you are witness that they are promising me that if I answer them, they will accept me as the Prophet. Then he said, I ask you by Allah, the one who has no partners, who revealed the Torah to Moses, do you know that the man's water is white and thick, and that the woman's water is yellow and thin? And any of the two waters gets above the other, gets the resemblance of child in his sex and characters by the will of Allah. Meaning, if a woman comes first, let's talk about color coding. The man's sperm is white and thick, and the woman's, eggs are yellow in color and they are thin. Now, if woman comes first, then the child will resemble to her. If man comes first, the child will resemble to him. So the Jews said, by Allah, what you said is true. The Prophet said, oh Allah, testify against them. Then he said, I ask you, by the one who revealed Torah to Moses, do you know that the eyes of this illiterate prophet sleep, but his heart does not? They said, by Allah, that's true. He said, oh Allah, testify against them. They said, you know, tell us about your guardians from angels. We will stay with you or leave you according to that. He said, my guardian is Jibreel. Prophet Muhammad said, my guardian is Jibreel. He comes to me with the revelations times and times. And Allah never sent any prophet, but he was his guardian. The Jews said, I don't know what happened to the Jews at this point, why they were not satisfied to these answers. And so the Jews said, we will separate from you had your guardian been another angel, not Jibreel. Actually, what the Jews actually had problem with Jibreel. Gabriel alayhi salam, they do not like him, So they said, if your guardian was another angel, we would have definitely followed you, Prophet Muhammad. But your guardian is Jibreel, we don't like him. Maybe they made some excuse. Maybe they were not satisfied on his, the replies, the answers of Prophet Muhammad. Allah knows the best. So brothers and sisters, hopefully I touched most of the questions that ever were asked Prophet Muhammad by his Jews. So if you like the video, brothers and sisters, please like this video, share this, and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Shalom alaikum, assalamu alaikum, goodbye.